Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Tuesday, November 27th. You're joining us now inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team here has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 34 crew members. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Tomas Gonzalez-Torres, and next to him serving as CAPCOM is Leslie Ringo, who's been relaying all ground messages up to the crew. Now aboard the International Space Station is Commander of the Complex, NASA astronaut Kevin Ford, with Flight Engineers Russian cosmonauts Oleg Novitsky and Yevgeny Tarelkin, who will work aboard the station as a three-member crew until the arrival of three new crew members in a couple weeks. Ford, Novitsky, and Tarelkin arrived at the International Space Station docking their Soyuz TMA-06M, shown here in this view, their spacecraft to the Poisk module last month on October 25th. And today they complete 36 days in space. The space station with its crew aboard is flying at an altitude of a little more than 260 statute miles. The orbiting facility is on an east-northeast track, swinging across the Southern Ocean just below the southern tip of Africa, soon to come across an orbital sunset. The Expedition 34 crew members began their day with some time this morning for work prep, breakfast, morning hygiene, and a daily station inspection. The crew then kicked off the day with the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Earlier this morning, Commander Ford had activated the in-space hardware for a science run of the In-Space 3, investigating the structure of paramagnetic aggregates from colloidal emulsions. This is a microgravity fluid physics experiment. Data from these studies may be used to improve or develop new brake systems, seat suspensions, robotics, clutches, airplane landing gear, and vibration damping systems. Commander Ford and Flight Engineers Novitsky and Tarelkin participated in an emergency medical procedures review. Ford also reviewed procedures for new upcoming data takes with the SPHERES experiment that employs three bowling ball free-flying satellites known as Synchronized Position Hold Engage Reorient Experimental Satellites. These are used to test techniques that could lead to advancements in automated dockings, satellite servicing, spacecraft assembly, and emergency repairs. And Commander Ford also took time this morning to talk with the reporters with WNDU-TV of Indiana, his hometown, and the Notre Dame Observer. Meanwhile, on the Russian side of the house, Flight Engineers Novitsky and Tarelkin will conduct Russian segment maintenance work today, cleaning air ducts and vacuuming behind panels in the Zvezda service module. Novitsky performed regular daily maintenance to the Soj, or the Russian life support system. And each of the crew members will put in their daily 2 hours of exercise using the onboard gym equipment that includes a station bicycle, a treadmill, and an advanced resistive exercise device that simulates weightlifting here on Earth. The crew then will wrap the day with a final daily planning conference with the ground and is then scheduled to go to bed at 3:30 p.m. Central Time. Meanwhile, robotics officers in Mission Control are commanding the Canada Arm 2 to walk off from the mobile base system power and data grapple fixture to the Harmony power and data grapple fixture in advance of a routine inspection of the space station robotic arm latching end effector. Here now we're getting a view of the that activity. It was reported just moments ago that the arm was in movement. And also back on Earth, three more crew members are in Star City, Russia, preparing for their launch next month to return the station to a six-member crew. At the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center, Expedition 34-35 Prime crew members Roman Romanenko, Tom Marshburn, and Chris Hadfield along with their backups, had conducted the first of 2 days of Russian Soyuz and Russian segment qualification exams and simulations today that will lead to their final certification for flight and a launch for the prime crew and their Soyuz TMA-07M spacecraft that will dock to the Rosviat module. That launch is scheduled to take place on December 19th from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. This is Mission Control Houston.